أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam، there is a period of time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to us as a believers, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 70 days, little bit more, it's a gift from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Between the Eidain, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, 2 days Allah give it for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first Eid after you fasting the whole month of Ramadan. And the second, after the Hajj, the day of Arafah. 2 Eid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to us within 70 days. Between these 2 Eid, then we have to stand, think, what happened in this period of time? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it very short? While we have the whole year 365 days or 366 days. If we think about it basically, we go by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَ أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَ مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His message, His deen, He wanna give it to everyone from who He created subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the sky and the earth and the mountain, everything rejected. They all rejected. Except Bani Adam, they took it. They take the amana that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give to them. But in this ayah, take one word, al-jibal, the mountains. In hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Tirmizi, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the earth, He wanna establish the earth. So He put the mountain in the top of the earth, so she cannot move. Then the malaika asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, this mountain is so huge, it's very strong, very heavy. Did you create anything else stronger than the mountain? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I create al-hadid, the iron, more strong than the mountain. Then the malaika ask again, "Oh Allah, is anything more stronger than al-hadid, than the iron?" And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Yes, the fire, more strong." "Oh Allah, is any more stronger than the fire?" He said, "Yes, the water." "Oh Allah, is any more stronger than the water?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Yes, al-riyah, the wind." "Oh Allah, is anything more stronger than the wind?" He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Bani Adam, you, my dear brothers and sisters, the one who gives sadaqah by his right hand and the left hand don't know anything about it. Isn't it gift from Allah? Who are stronger than the mountain and than the iron, than the water, than the wind by the sadaqah? See how the importance of the sadaqah is? But the mountain, as strong, can be destroyed. It. Now they pump it, they make buildings. Human being can do a lot on it. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, no one can touch it except Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. He's Allah. But today, my dear brothers and sisters, we're going to talk about a very strong mountains. Two mountains. Until the day of judgment, these two mountains will be remained. No one can touch it. Those mountains is from blood, from meat, heart, soul, say whatever you want, human beings. These two mountains remind us what happened in these 70 days. The first one, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the second, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We believe all the prophets. But in these days, you have two of them. We have to remember them what happened, what they did for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is can solve a lot of problems in our life if we're concerned about it. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in this very period, very short of times? Because you come after the fasting in the month of Ramadan. So are good, your soul is good, you're still interesting to give. You're still interesting to pray, you're still interesting to memorizing, you're still interesting to read the Quran, you're still interesting to sit down with your family, eat with your family. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is after that, "Come, I will give you another Eid." But we have to stop to see what happened to these two prophets make us concerned about it in these days. Of course, all the time we have to concern, but mainly in this time, every year, we have to read the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he gave us a beautiful example when he got the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be a prophet. He has a parents. He's telling us, when your parents are alive and you're not married, the first person you run and you speak to him is your father. Ya abati, لِمَا تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعْ وَلَا يُبَصِرْ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. He ran to his father and he spoke to him. "Oh father, why you pray and you pray and you make bow for the mouth, for the idol you created by your hand? They don't hear, they don't talk." But after his discussion, and we know all the stories, we're not about it today to talk about it today. After the discussion with his father and he rejected and he asked him to stay away from him, he gave us another lesson, but moved to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was an orphan. He has no parents. They passed away. At this time when he got the message, he was married. Now Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us another example. When he got the message and he has no parents alive, he ran to whom? To his wife Khadija radiallahu anha wa ardaha, and he said to her, "Dathrini, dathrini, dathrini. Cover me, cover me, cover me." You get my message, my dear brothers and sisters? You run to whom if you have no parents alive? Your wife. That's the one make it for you halal. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his father rejected the message, he didn't say any bad word to his father. He just made dua to his father. سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي. I make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did he curse his father? Did he say bad words to his father? So he gave us an example. You have to be humble, kind, and calm when you talk to your father. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he gave the example. When everyone from Quraysh gave him hard time and punish and throw the stone and do a lot of them, he didn't make dua. He just says his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them to for the right thing for the Islam, to be a Muslim. These two mountains, my dear brothers and sisters, they telling us how we can build a family. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he's telling us, if you have something, you have to run directly to the Creator. When they give him a hard time, his father and the tribe, what did he say? He said, "Inni dhahibun ila Rabbi sayahdeen." I'm going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will guide me. Guide him to migrate from Iraq to Palestine, to Egypt, to Palestine, to Mecca. Travel. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the sad year when his wife died and his uncle died and everybody gave him hard time, and he raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him another direction. He said, "Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come up. We welcome you up. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa alladhi barakna hawla." And then he let him migrate from Mecca to Medina. So both of them, they're running for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he gave us an example. When you move somewhere, there is a family with you. He took his wife with him. He never neglected, he never leave his wife. Unless Allah gives him the order to leave his wife with his son, he's listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's telling us, when you have a family, you have to be worried and care about it. When he took his wife with him to Egypt, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his way to any battle or any direction, he take his wife with him the same way. But for us, in the dunya, we let the dunya catch us. We love the dunya. We love the dunya, my dear brothers and sisters. But if you love the dunya and what's in the dunya, remember, in the end you have one thing. Small piece has a hole, they call grave. You will go in it. That's it. That's what you gain from the dunya. But if you do everything as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have Jannah. عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the wideness as earth and the sky, this is gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the people who say, "La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah." But how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was dealing with his wife? Because that's what we need to learn. How he was talking to Fatima, his daughter. That's what we need to learn. And we take this message from the mountain Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to our house to deal with it. He make their life very easy and simple and lovely. He was joking with them all the time. Sayyida Sauda, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she would sit down with Sayyida Aisha, and Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha radha, she cooked some food. But she gave it to Sayyida Sauda, she doesn't want to eat. She said, "No." She said, "If you don't want to eat, I'm going to put it in your face. I take some, I put it in your face." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam between them. Then she did. Sayyida Sauda, she removed it from her face, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Give it to her back." And he was laughing between them. He never curse. He never say a bad word. He make fun with them. He eats slowly so he can clean the dishes. He was making race with them inside the house. He take the idea from them, negotiation, shura. He's telling us, when you have a children, you care about it. He loved Fatima. When she come, radiallahu anha warda, from the door, he stand, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and hug her and give a kiss. Fatima bint Khadija, the daughter of Khadija. He remember Khadija when she died. So he cared about her friend, This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do we carry that inside our house? Do we give a hug to our daughter or our son? Because a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he's hugging Qais al-Hasan al-Husayn, and he said to him, that's how we treat the boys? You give them a hug and kiss? He said, yes, you don't do that. He said, Wallah, I have 10. I never do that. You have to be strong. He said for him, go and change your heart. The deen of Allah is very simple, my dear brothers and sisters. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was follow up with his family every time he leave and come back and worry about them. But the hair, the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to Ibrahim alayhi salam is great. The Hajj. When he was in Mecca and nothing around him, and he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this place rich as we see it today, very rich by the dua of Ibrahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, oh Ibrahim, I give you something beautiful because you listen to me all the time. Even when I ask you to sacrifice your son, you just listen to me and you're gonna do it. But the question, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to sacrifice his son, not his wife? That would be great in our time. You say, oh, we wish Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't do it for us who slaughtered the sheep. Why? Because the relation between the father and son is very important. When you grow as a man, this is the one you depend on him. And you are young, you're taking care of them. But the wife, she's the mother, no one can touch her heart. You cannot touch her child in front of her. Period. And she's the one who can get the baby for you. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and remember that very well, when they ask them, where are you from? Do you want to find where is his place when he got her time? He said, Ana min ma, I am from a water. But he meant something else. He's from father and mother. That's what he meant sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Without the mother, we are nothing. And I'm stating very clear. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala see the wife is not important, he will never give it to Adam alayhi salam. Life can go with the malaika. Life can go with only Adam alone by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he loved the human being. He liked the man to be strong by his wife. We have different job, muscles. Allah give it to us. But they give them a lot. Rahmah and kind. That's more than anything. They give them sabr. And that's what we learn from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has sabr with them. When they get angry, he never cursed them. He never say bad word. He was cooled down sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, we think when we get married, they are slaves. They're not, my dear brothers and sisters. They need your help. When you married them, you get them from a beautiful house, a parents, spend a lot of money to treat them very well as you are. You should understand too, at the same time, your parents spend plenty of money to make you a really good man, but the life has to go by the book of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the ni'mah to Ibrahim alayhi salam because he was running to him all the time. The Hajj and the manasik of the Hajj, we learn it from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through Jibreel alayhi salam. And the Hajj became a fard. If you have the money and you don't go to the Hajj, you commit a sin. You must do it once in your life. Yes, we do understand it's getting very expensive, but still we run for it. We love to see the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Ya Ibrahim, just call them. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَىٰ كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعًا لَهُمْ. وَاذْكُرْ اسْمَ اللَّهِ. Remember in Allah, the house of Allah. This is the ni'mah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to Ibrahim. You see the Hajj and the Umrah and how many people over there, they give us an example. We are one united, no different the color or anything else or the tongue or the language or anything. We're all one going there to say labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, innal hamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika laka labbaik. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he know the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He can make sense. But he talked to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's another gift. The month of Ramadan,
fasted the whole month, prayed the whole month, reciting the Quran, listening to Quran. This is the two mountains. They give us a lot of example. The gathering, every time after Ramadan, you see the Eid. Come to the masjid in the Jum'ah, see how many people, and go to the Eid prayer and see how many people. Same thing at the Eid al-Adha. See how many people would be there, my dear brother. You would be shocked. We have a lot of Muslims. Islam is everywhere in the earth. This is the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we study the seerah of these two mountains, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ibrahim alayhi salam, you see our houses will get beautiful. If we understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are sinners, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive. أولم يعلموا أن الله يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء ويقدر إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgive all the sins. الإمام الغزالي رحمة الله عليه, he saw a man drunk. Then he come closer to him. He said, brother, how you remember Allah? Why you are doing that? You shouldn't do it. This is haram. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, don't drink. This is haram. Alcohol is haram. He started to cry. Imam al-Ghazali look at him and he said, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. He makes sins and he cry. And we are sinners and we don't cry. Brother, come with me. And he catch him and say, just say, we have to say it together to Allah, رَبَّنَا إِنَّا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. We come together to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't ask the imam for it. Ask for you and your family. Because we make mistakes. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, two things he's asking the Muslim people. We cannot do it when they ask him, Ya Rasulullah, Al-Muslim yazni, they can make adultery, say yes. Yasr, he can steal, he said yes. Yakzib, can lie, he said no, cannot. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَنْ غَشَّنَا فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا. The one who is cheating is not among us. But remember that. When he said that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this word, if you don't cheat, you're not going to do the others. If you not lie, you're not going to do the others. Because if you make a sin or something, you do it secretly. If we ask you, you're going to say, I didn't, then you all lie. So all of them complicated together. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very smart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave us the advice. Between Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam, a lot of stories, my dear brothers and sisters, to tell us how we solve the problem inside our houses. How we keep the houses secret. Anything come out of your house and my house, getting bigger and bigger and bigger. We have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to think about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he kissed the Hassan al-Hussein, when he's talking to Fatima, when he's talking to his wife. We have to do the same thing. The Islam will be better. The mother, if you treat her very well, your house will be perfect. If you give her the sabr and the hanan and the love, that's what she needs from you. Beautiful words make her very happy. Same thing when you come tired from your work and you see her waiting for you and give you beautiful words, smiling in your face, dressed very well, you don't need anything else. They are covered for you and you are covered for them. Without them, we are nothing. And they are without us, they are nothing. Among us, a beautiful flowers, kids grow. We love them. We need them to look at our faces and how we love each other so they grow up the same way. If they see the parents getting problem, they hate to get married. We don't need that, my dear brothers and sisters. We have a beautiful kids. Do you love the Islam as we love the Islam? But this is the time we need to discuss with them the seerah of Ibrahim alayhi salam and the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us, if we didn't do the Hajj, go for the Hajj again and again and again to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His house as we remember Him all the time until the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jannat al-Na'im, because when you are in the Jannah, you're going to meet all the prophets, you're going to meet all the Malaika, you're going to see everything, you're going to see your son, you're going to see your wife, you're going to see your brother, your father, your mother, you're going to see everything. The Jannah only for the people who say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا، كفر عنا سيئاتنا، اشف مرضانا، ارحم أمواتنا، تولنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات، المسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين، اقبض أرواحنا وأنت راض عنا. نسألك يا ربنا الجنة ونعيمها، ونعوذ بك يا ربنا من النار وشرورها. اللهم استر عوراتنا وعورات نسائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلينا يا كريم. اللهم اجعلنا عونا لإخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، انصر إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان، انصر الأقصى يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم ثبتهم، اللهم مدهم بعون من عندك. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين، الفقراء ملوا أرض المسلمين، فكن معهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اكرمهم، اللهم اطعمهم، اللهم اسقيهم، اللهم اجعلنا عونا لهم. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين، اغفر لنا الذنوب، كفر عنا السيئات. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. عباد الله، رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.